每个企业都跟我们的生命一样，我们会在生意上感到绝望、迷失，或者是太多选择。当然，我们会走到成功的道路上。每逢星期一到星期五上午10点和下午3点，我们都会邀请 Singapore Excellent Award 的得主上我们的节目，跟我们分享他们的心路旅程，还有他们的成功的道路。这个节目是由 Singapore Enrich Group 荣誉呈现。感谢您收看这一期的封面人物。在直播室今天哈、有一个非常独一无二、很特别的一个男士要来到节目当中接受我们今天的专访。为什么说独一无二呢？我是这样觉得啦，明明就是高材生嘛，在学业上交出漂亮的成绩单，不过呢，这是我们亚洲哈、甚至可能是我们华人，或者是包括在新加坡的父母，很多都说，哎，玩音乐、有音乐的梦想是很不切实际的。很多时候父母亲当听到他的小孩子要朝向音乐或艺术甚至广播这方面发展的时候都很紧张。所以今天呢，来到直播室的是一个非常成功的企业家，同时呢，在他的学业上也交出漂亮的成绩单。我们这时候马上邀请我们的嘉宾 James 到节目当中。
Hello，
你好 James。
好。
James 是来自 My Drum School 的负责人哦，从事这个生意呢已经有5年了。
对，
这5年一路走来还好吗？
还可以，
还可以哦。刚才我们在开始介绍你之前，就说其实你是一名高材生哦，在学校交出蛮漂亮的成绩单哦。
可以，还可以。
不要说还可以啦，事实就是这样子嘛。我知道你是在NTU 南洋 Technology 学校里面呢，是读商科的，
然后还有 IT
business 和 IT， 然后就是。Top of the core， 是 Dean List 呢？
Dean List 3年，
3年 Dean List 啊，怪不得永远不知哦一哦啊。所以，当你爸爸妈妈听到说你是高材生的时候，他们应该是很开心吧？
对，当然，
应该是祖宗显灵、光宗耀祖那种感觉吧？
对，因为我小时候，学业不是很好，
学业并不是很好，
对，所以我。到大学的时候，拿到Dean's List First Class Honors， 他们当然很开心了。
哇，还记得当时的努力是很一定很多吧？付出很多的努力吧。
对，可是我也是喜欢读嘛，喜欢读 business， 好像很他们对我说好像很容易这样啊。对我同学，他们
读得很辛苦，
不同意啊。
那你爸爸妈妈是不是有人在家里有人从商的？
没有。
爸爸妈妈从事什么行业呢？
我妈妈是个老师
啊，
爸爸是做IT 的了。
这样奇怪哦。
对，他有做一点 business
小生意
啊。对，有。
所以其实从小到大就看到爸爸妈妈是如何工作，
对，
但是也没有真正一个从商的环境，
对，
所以爸爸只是经营一些小本生意来做。
小呀，对。
这样为什么你会在 business admin 这些科目考了这么好呢？
我是不懂。本来喜欢读音乐的，可是我爸爸叫我去读 business， 因为他以前也是有读过 business， 读过 marketing， 所以就跟他了。
所以就听他的话，
听他的话跟他去读，对，
去读 marketing， 就是读 business，
对，读 business， then discovered 很好咯 ，yeah。
有后悔吗？在当时因为当时你要读音乐的时候，爸爸妈妈却强力的反对，
对，
他们鼓励你去读就是商科，
对，
当时的心情是怎样
子？当然很伤心，可是当我读 business 在尼安伯里的时候。我觉得我成绩很好啊，所以比较对我来说比较好咯。
有当时有恨爸爸妈妈吗？
没有了，没有，因为我懂
叛逆。
因为我懂他们是关心，然后叫我在新加坡，如果你做music， 可能没有 career，
是，
所以他说 at least 去拿一个 diploma， 才。then see how，
其实很多父母亲都是同样的担忧哦。
对对，
现在你已经是人家的爸爸了，
对，
身为人家的父亲哦，将来以后你的小孩也是跟你一样说，爸，我要做一些怪怪的行业，因为你是要音乐嘛。
对对。
其实新加坡乐坛里面也教出蛮多漂亮成绩单的音乐人。
对，现在比较好的。
对对对，现在有杰伊啊，还有陈焕仁啊，小韩老师啊，
对，
有蛮多的，不像以前蛮少的哈。
对。
所以今天你小孩如果来去做一个冷门的工作，可能是画家，打比方，画家，或者是去 busking 去到街头演艺表演的话，怎么办？
我会跟他坐下来，跟他讲了，
然后
我会让他，可能我会让他选呢、啊，不会逼他做，我要他做什么了，won't force her to take over my business or him， you know I got one boy and one girl， so sit them down， talk to them， yeah，
wow，
对了，
所以when you decided to make a career switch after you joined the corporate world for about 8 months,
it's difficult.
It was a difficult choice for you.
Definitely, because I was on a top program. I was actually
management trainee. Okay.
It's a advisory role.
Okay.
So doing very well. Gonna get promoted.
Wow! Within 8 months, you're gonna get promoted.
Yeah. Within 8 months.
To which level?
Senior level.
Okay.
So, in fact, I already skipped 2 levels when I joined this company. So, it was a tough decision. It's a very unknown path.
Sure.
Yeah, 因为新加坡很少人去做音乐的生意嘛。
是。
很难survive, 很多人讲。所以go and try. Yeah, so I went to try.
所以当你决定去 try 的时候，what was your parents' reaction then?
Supportive, but yet a bit hesitant.
Because they embark on an unknown journey.
对, and because all along I didn't do well in school. Finally, I did well in university. I was top of the class, and they just want to make sure I know what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, 很多人讲做生意你不用grades, 你不用 degree 去做嘛？为什么？you know, my parents asked me, 为什么你高学你要现在才决定去做 ？So, but they were supportive. 他们也是给我一点 loan， loan 我一点钱去开始。
当时有女朋友了没有？还是结婚了？
有女朋友。
所以女朋友对你的反应是什么
呢？她很 supportive 啊。她 yeah, in fact, she's the one who is now my wife. Who pushed me to go out to find a place.
To get out of your comfort zone.
对对 ，starting 我只是做好像 private， few students， 他叫我去找一个 permanent 的地方， uh-huh. 去 hire staff and 去 yeah。
所以当时哦，因为有老婆、女朋友，当时女朋友现在的老婆的鼓励跟支持情况下，就是你找了第一个店，
对，
找了第一个办公室，然后就开始自己的教学生涯。所以记得当时的心情是什么样子的吗 ？Because from an employed guy、with death, you know, with
fixed
and good salary, from now jump into budgeted amount.
对 definitely calculated risk. 不是说我有好像输很多钱这样啊 ，because 刚开始而已嘛。所以 it's a better position to go out and start something.Then if 如果我做工做5年 ，I think 是比较难出来。But definitely a lot of uncertainties. But a lot of supportive friends, family that made everything very easy.
所以当时你自己多少时间呢？就在这生意上，如果失败的话就回家。
For the first year, 我在我的office 睡。
Wow.
我 first year 因为我要做全部东西。From 洗厕所 to you know to painting to 这些 very hands on 做自己的生意不可以说，妈妈去帮我洗厕所吗？所以要自己做，比较难了。
这一年来在办公室睡了一整年，花了一整年的时间 当时有没有一丝的后悔，或者是一丝的想放弃，还是让你激励你勇往直前？
没有啊，没有。Never thought of regret， 因为all along since we started 是 actually 09我出来的时候是 recession year 来的
，correct，
所以
it's 2008 there's the economic crisis，
correct correct， so
啊
2009 end of that then 我出来
，okay，
so it's the in Singapore， it hit Singapore in 09，
correct，
but 已经like lowest level 了嘛 Singapore， 所以我做生意 it only can get better 咯。So as more students like as economy gets better， 生意也是比较好咯。
刚刚跟我们介绍一下 My Jump School 其实主要的生意主要的焦点是在哪里的？ What's the main focus on the business？
我们 our tagline 是 We are serious about drumming。You know when I was 17 years oldI wanted to learn drums in Singapore, and there were only like two drum schools, or two schools offering drum music program. So I had to learn from like a private teacher. So there's a lack of education, drum education in Singapore. And so that's the first focus. Why we started the school is because a lot of people want to learn drums, but there is no good place to do it.Second, of course, we want to inspire people. We want to spread on a skill. We want to teach people the right methods for drumming.
I thought drumming just so bang 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 that's all.
Oh, got a lot more. Got exam.
Are you sure?
Yes, there's grade 1 to grade 8 and a diploma.
Just like piano.
Just like piano.
So
yeah.
From grade 1 to grade 8 and a diploma, how much time do you need to invest?
Maybe from grade 1 to 5, it can do it every half a year.
Okay.
But 5 onwards, you need 1 year at least. So it will take you aboutSame as piano, around there.
About 8 years, plus my investment.
Plus, yeah.
So how many years did you invest?
I've been drumming for about 15 years.
Okay.
About that.
Wow, so you mentioned that firstly, your school is just to focus on to provide an outsource of drumming.
Correct,
and
yes.
also to provide formal education
yes,
on drumming itself.
Definitely.
So is there any third area or fourth area?
I think that is our main focus. We are a specialized school, that's why it's called My Drum School.We don't offer like guitar lessons or singing
yes,
and other things.
Yes, yes.
So yeah, we are very focused on what we want to do and achieve in Singapore.
So what are your dream passions?
We want to see more centers in Singapore.
Oh, by you.
we already have two at the moment. But there are a lot of people that still want to have a center near their house.
Sure.
So we have one in the north at Ang Mo Kio, one at Lavender in the central area.So we want to have one in the east and the west, and after that, we want to do something internationally.
Any plans to go into franchise since you are a top student in business admin?
Franchising model doesn't really help us at the moment.
Okay.
So I think we will still open the branches ourselves,
sure.
Because we want to control the standard, right? As well as I think a lot of people doing franchise, the danger is they may just see it as an avenue to make money.
Definitely.
But we want to make sure that this is an education, that our primary focus is to educate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we want to do it like that, expand.
So I'm with a first class honors and on top of the dean list for 3 years with the knowledge. How do you manage to transfer your knowledge that you accumulated in school to your business?
Definitely a lot, because in school we study law, we study marketing, we study HR, operations, IT and stuff. So every area is handled by me.
Okay.
I do all my own brochures, right?
Wow.
I have to learn Photoshop, I have to do my own website. I've created a new, my own HR program, hire people, interview people. So a lot of these things, we don't have receptionists in our school. So it's very strange because usually when you walk in a music school, you will find a recept at a desk, you know,
right.
How can I help you? But for us, our teachers will come out and talk to you, so it's more personal.
So your teacher must double as
admin staff.
Admin staff,
yes.
Receptionists and also
we pay them a bit more. So at least we can save the money from the secretary fees. And then we pass it on to our teachers.
Mm-hmm.
So actually we pay quite well in the industry. In fact, one of the top...
compared to the rest of your
correct,
competitors.
Yes, yeah. So yeah, I handle a lot of the business aspects. But I think in Singapore it's very easy because there are a lot of things available on websites.
Mm-hmm.
So things like on IRAS website, on ACRA,
yeah,
and all the CPF, everything, there is a...
Tell me about it.
Yeah, there is a to-do, you know, kind of document for you to do, and you can call the helpline.
Alright.
So it's very, very useful. It's very, I find it's very easy to do the business in Singapore. Yeah, yeah, it's like really, everything is listed down, black and white, you know, very transparent. Yeah.
So after having a successful drum school, so what is next on your plate? Any plans for any other new businesses?
Well, I think we are still trying to be more stable, right? We want to make sure that we can sustain our business. We have about 17 employees, so I just want to make sure that before I hop on to any new venture or new idea, that this school is really stable first. Yeah.
Sure. Mm. So can I say that you are still the first and only director in the company?
So yes, of course.
There's
yeah.
no other new.
I have a my brother is a sleeping partner,
sure.
So two of us own the company. And but at the moment we have no plans to sell.
Expanded.
Yeah, or convert to private limited. Yeah.
Wow. Mm. Okay. So when you first knew that my drum school was being nominated and being awarded with excellent award, so what came to mind then?
It is definitely a milestone for us. It is an encouragement as well to tell us that we are doing something right. We are actually impacting some, you know, impacting the industry as well as the community of drummers. So it's a really good encouragement for the school, for the staff team, as well as for myself. And it pushes us, you know, to want to excel greater. It makes us want to really, you know, take it more seriously that, you know, now that we have this award, we want to make sure that we can live, you know, to the integrity of the award. And it's really a blessing for us.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah. So. Yeah, thanks.
So you feel very happy about it.
Definitely.
So yeah. Any plans to bring your kids to this industry of
yours? Of course. So yeah, my little girl is 2 now.
Uh-huh.
So she's been holding the drumsticks. She recognizes the drum set. And but I think at a young age, it's still quite hard to tell.
But do you bring her to your school compound?
Of course, yeah. She loves it there. Can't get her out. So she just keep hitting the drums, you know, papa, drums. And yeah. But they like it, yeah. Mm.
Oh, you
see, it's very
happy. You seem to be a very proud father.
Yeah.
So actually, in fact, 可以这样讲的就是说, 现在有小孩了, your life, you have your own business, you are married with kids. Your life should be quite complete at this point of time itself. Any new challenges for you to embark on? Or to conquer?
I think parenting, definitely.
Uh-huh.
So, raising up children. And of course, because I have a staff team under me, so really trying to build a strong staff team, you know, help. Because, I mean, each of them, my staff are also married, they also have kids. You know, so I want to just make sure that
holistic teams,
yeah, I continue to inspire, continue to impart. I still teach drum lessons myself. I have, you know, more than 20 over students because I like to teach. Yeah,
I can be one of your students.
Yeah,
I'm tone deaf.
Yeah, no, don't worry. Nothing to do with singing or tune or anything.
Are you sure?
Mm, it's just coordination. Do you drive?
I can.
If you can drive, do you swim?
Yes.
Can.
I used to be a lifeguard.
Can, because people who find it hard to swim or drive actually have maybe quite poor coordination skills.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because to swim you have to have certain strokes.
Definitely.
And at the same timing, if not you will just drown.
Uh-huh.
And to drive you have to have you have to focus on the road, on your gear, check your blind spot. Some people can't do it.
Okay.
Usually, I mean, they always say lady drivers, but it's not true. In my school, more than 60% are ladies.
Oh.
So ladies have quite good sense of coordination.
It's
yeah.
the men who might be weak at it.
Maybe. So you should try.
Okay, let's make a date. I will go over to the school itself to learn
it's
how
nearby.
To play drum.
Yeah.
是的。所以你看，今天来到节目当中哦，有一个年轻的企业家。 从事一个行业呢是非常特别的，是音乐界哦。很多人都说，哎，其实哦，从事音乐、从事艺术这方面呢，可能比较难赚到钱，吃饭养家糊口。 这是铁板的事实。其实不单单只在音乐界，只要你往出来闯的话，只要从事自己的生意的话，你只要迈向你的创业旅程，其实这就是你要先开始克服的一个其中一个障碍之一。在节目结束之前呢，我们再次问一下我们今天受访的嘉宾 James 哦 ，James before we call it day for the recording for the interview session itself, is there any words to share with our viewers or listeners on this entrepreneurship journey?
I think the main thing about life in general is a lot of people want to choose a job that earns a lot of money. You know, and I was there, you know, I was a top student, I was getting the money, I was getting, you know, very high standing in the corporate ladder. But I think at the end of the day, we really have to ask ourselves, what do we really want to wake up every day and look forward, you know, to? What is our passion in life? What really satisfies us? Money will come, definitely, be patient with it. But if you really want to start a business, don't do it for the money, but do it because you like what you do. And the passion is the thing that will drive you through your ups and downs, through your discouragement, through times where you feel like giving up. It's the passion that will drive you forward to bring the business to a new level. So, yep, I think in life, enjoy what you do, because that's the thing that you will smile to every morning. You know,
是的，好，刚才 James 所讲的真的是很重要。每天早上起床第一件事情，你是拉着你的尸体去上班的，还是哦耶，走去上班了？每个星期一你就知道了，到底 Monday 你没有 Blue Monday 就很好的写照了哈。现在很多时候呢，很多人以为说，哎，做生意一定会赚钱哦，但是做生意不是每个人都会赚钱的，当然多数的人做生意都一定会赚钱，只不过说这门生意哦，是不是你聚焦的兴趣？当你在遇到挑战的时候，是金钱还是你的兴趣催促你、逼迫你往前走呢？这只有你自己才知道了。我是阿宝，非常感谢你们收看这一期的封面人物，我们下一期再见。